新しいの現実のカードを蘇れ。 What's up YouTube, this is Undisputed 22 back here again, this time for another unboxing video. And today, right in front of me, we have the brand new Vanguard Booster Pack DBT08. So yeah, this is the DBT08 that I have been waiting for. Inside contains support for, I mean, as you can see here, the cover card, we have Minerva, which is a Genesis unit, which is also an encounter card. Yes, and this pack has a few encounter cards. So the cover card is Minerva, and behind the box we have the other cards inside as well. We have Lukie, another encounter card for Pale Moon, which is Dark Stage. And we have my personal favorite, Soranryu Maelstrom for Stochea. Then we have the Dragon Empire unit, and then we have a Brangate unit. So yeah, I'm very excited to open this box and let's get started. So I have a total of two boxes here. So what I'm looking forward to get is of course the Maelstrom cards, because I'm planning to build Maelstrom. But hey, you might never know, we might be lucky enough to, in order to pull the numbered Minerva. Yes, there is a special printed numbered Minerva that is, I think, same as the numbered Phantom Blaster Dragon, I'm not too sure. And of course the secrets for the Maelstrom and the Lukie. So I tried to open this box but it doesn't let me cut here. Okay, I got it. Alright, so this is the first part. I really hoping we get a high rarity Maelstrom, or any, or honestly speaking, any high rarity whatever. So this is something similar to the DBT05, except instead of SPs like the DBT05, we are getting frame rest FR. So okay, so this is our box topper. We get a sleeve, so this is like a Hololife sleeve. As you can see here, there's a Hololife icon and the Vanguard icon. Yeah, this pack has a special Hololife collab. So yeah, that explains why this pack is getting quite hyped now at the moment. So let's just see what we get. So for a Vanguard box, we have a total of 16 packs, am I wrong? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8. Yep, 16 packs. One pack has, I think, 9 to 10 foils? I can't remember. So yeah, it's been a while since I opened a Vanguard booster pack. So let's just see what we get here. So first pack, and we have a double R for Dragon Empire. So let's carry on here. Okay, so we have another double R. This is a double R for Stochea, and we have a triple R. We have an encounter card. This is Angelica, very nice. So this is for victory support for Genesis. It's for Minerva. So let's just go through what Angelica does, shall we? All right. So we have Regalia of Wisdom Angelica. So auto on rearguard circle. Yes, auto on rearguard circle. Where at the end of the battle that this unit attacks, if you have a Vanguard with Minerva in his card name called Soul Blast 1, choose one of your Vanguards to get off a 5k until the end of turn. Also, put this unit into your Soul Counter Charge 1. So yeah, it's a counter charger for Minerva, which is pretty good. And he puts herself into the Soul, which is also very good because Minerva needs like a grade 3 Genesis unit in order to have a passive 5k to a rearguard circle. So yeah, it's pretty good. That's our first triple R. And we got the double R for the Stochea. Pretty good start. Okay, let's see here. This is a double rare pack. And we got who's this again? Teal, Tier Knight Teal. One of the great ones I need for my Maelstrom deck. That is the right line. Okay, another double rare pack. Oh, they reprinted the starter for Tama Yugure. It's pretty cool. Okay, double rare pack. Hey, we got Algos, which is good. Then this is the brand new deck for Brungate. This is the monster deck, if I'm not wrong. And we have the Lukie order, which is really strong. Right, attack. Right, and we have a triple R. This is for Brungate. This is a EVA support card, so let's see what it does. Alright, so we have Great Sword of the Ferocious Black Flame Obsidian. So, auto on Rearguard Circle, Guardian Circle, if your order zone has 3 or more set orders, this unit gets power plus 5k, shield plus 5k, active on your opponent's turn 2. Second skill, Glitter, EVA, active if your Vanguard is Glitter with EVA in its card name. Continuous Rearguard Circle, when this unit is placed on Rearguard Circle by your card's ability, this turn, and your order zone has 3 or more research cards. When this unit attacks, it battles all of your opponent's units in the front row. So yeah, this is basically a Dragonic Kaiser Vermilion on Rearguard Circle, and if you have 3 or more orders, research orders, it becomes a Vermilion, and it only works with EVA. So yeah, this card is really strong. And if you notice, it's a Peter Century and a Brungate card, so which is cool. So yeah, that's pretty good. So that's our second triple R, very nice. Okay, this is a double R. This is a double R for... looks like Chaos. And we got a Frame Rare. Okay, so nice. This is a double R Frame Rare. For Peter Century, this is the Counter Charger. It's a generic Counter Charger, which is pretty cool. Okay, that's good. Last pack for the right side, let's see what we get. And we end off with a double rare pack, but we do get one of the right lines for Pale Moon, Lupier. Pretty good. So our right side, we managed to pull an FR, 3 double Rs and 2 triple Rs. Not a bad start. So yeah, let's move on to the left side. Here. Let's see what else we get. I'm hoping to pull a Maelstrom at least, because I need Maelstrom. I want to build Maelstrom. Maelstrom is pretty so fun. And we got another double rare pack. Hey, Skunko Jose Eric, the starter for Arcovos. Next. We got a triple R, and yes, just nice, I mentioned, we got it. Soran Maelstrom, there we go. This is the card I wanted to pull and the deck I wanted to make. Sadly, in triple R version, but I'll gladly take it. So, this is Maelstrom in this series, so let's go through what Maelstrom does, shall we? Alright, Blue Storm Dragon Maelstrom. Continuous active on Vanguard Circle once per turn. Discard a card from your hand, choose a unit card with only Aqua Force in its clan or Tear Dragon from your soul, call it to a Rearguard Circle, and until the end of that turn, get auto or Rearguard Circle when this unit attacks. If your opponent's Vanguard is grade 3 or greater, and it is the first battle of that turn, cost Counterblast 1, stand this unit. At the end of the turn, put that unit back into your soul. Second skill, when this unit attacks a Vanguard and it is the fourth or more battle of that turn, retire, choose an opponent's rear guard and retire it and draw a card. So yeah, this is the D-Series Maelstrom. Its first ability is really good. It gives you, it lets you superior core unit from your soul every single turn by discarding a card, and it lets you, and lets that rear guard have a restanding skill, which is really strong, and it lets you call an Arc of Force or Tear Dragon. So that means you can call any of your Arc of Force units, you can call Inland Pulse as well, because Inland Pulse is a Tear Dragon, and it gives the restanding skill as well. So yeah, so this card is just amazing, and it has the OG Limit Break 4 effect of the old Maelstrom, which is pretty cool. Sadly, I wish this was the V-Series Maelstrom, man. If this was the V-Series Maelstrom, when it firstly came out, this card, the deck would have been so much better, but we got the V-Series Maelstrom instead. So yeah, that's very nice. Glad to see Maelstrom over here. So that's one triple R that I wanted to pull. So let's carry on with the pack opening. Okay, we have a double R. This is a new research order for Eva, which is a great tree. That's very nice. Okay, another double rare pack. Okay, let's carry on. And we have a double R. So this is the double R that I put just now for the FR. So this is the generic counter charger for Keter Century. It's pretty good. Okay, double rare pack again. Okay, triple R for Dragon Empire, and we got an FR for the Brungate. I believe this is a double R. So yeah, we got a triple R for Dragon Empire. Let's just go through what it does. Alright, so we have Stealth Dragon Uprisiden. So auto when this unit is placed on Regal Circle by your card's ability. If you have a Vanguard with Tamayura or Shoujo Doji in its card name, cost Soul Blast 1 and draw a card. Continuous on Rare Guard Circle, if two or more cards were put from Rare Guard Circle into your soul, this turn this unit gets power plus 10k. So yeah, this is a Tamayura support, which is pretty good. Tamayura is basically the Dragon Empire deck from the DBT 05, which has gotten boost. So yeah, this is a very good grid tree boost. So yeah, that's pretty cool. I mean, this FR, remember, it's a double R for Brungate. Alright, last pack from the left side. Let's see what we get for the last pack. And we have another triple R. Okay, so we have an EX. So this is a new rarity, and it looks like one of the Hololife cards. Okay, that's pretty cool. That's interesting. So I'm guessing this is a brand new rarity. It's called EX. So yeah, let's just read through what this does. Alright guys, so sad to say, I cannot find the translation for this card yet. It has not been updated yet. So yeah, this is one of the new Hololife cards for Lyrica Mosterio. So yes, EX04 is a great 1-8K. So I'm not sure what it does. But yeah, that's our last foil for the box. So let's just go through our first box. So we have a total of one EX rare. I'm not sure what is that. Then we have 1, 2, 3, 4 triple R's, 2 encounter cards, which is Maelstrom and Angelica, which is pretty nice. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 double R's and 2 FR. So yeah, that's our first box. I have to say our first box is pretty good. We got Maelstrom. I'm happy that I put Maelstrom. So yeah, that's our first box. So now let's clear up all the rubbish and move on to the second box, shall we? Alright guys, we are back. Let's move on to the next box here. This last box here. Let's hope we get an FFR for any of those cards. So, yep, let's see. Okay, so our box topper, we got the same sleeve. I don't know, do we get random sleeves or is it like the same sleeve every single box? So, but yeah, that's the sleeves. Same sleeve again. Okay, let's move open the box, shall we? Right side first. Okay, our first pack, we got a double R for Tamayugure. It's an order. Tamayura, sorry. Right, next pack. And we have a triple R and we have an FR for the monster deck. So yeah, let me just put the FR here. And this triple R is the new Brungate card. I believe this is the boss monster for the new monster deck. So let's go through what it does. Okay, so we have Monster Creator Archite. So skill is auto on Vanguard Circle when your rare guard with monster in its card name is placed. Cost, put a card with the same card name as that unit from your order zone to the bottom of your deck. And that unit gets power plus 10k until the end of the turn. Auto, when this unit attacks, if your order zone has a research card, because Counterblast 1 perform all of the following. If your AutoZone has 3 or more research cards, choose up to one of your rare guards with monster in his card name and put it into your AutoZone. Look at the top 7 cards of your deck. Choose up to one unit card with monster in his card name from among them, call it to rare guard circle and shuffle your deck.
Wow, that's a long text right there. Okay, so basically, this is a brand new deck for Frontgate, and it focuses on monsters, which is the FR that I put. Yeah, so these two go together, and it's quite interesting. They basically put like monster rare guards into your order zone, then you call them out, and then they gain power. Yeah, it's pretty quite a creative way of playing. So yeah, that's pretty cool. So first trip R. Next pack, we have a double rare pack. And we have a triple R, this nice. Okay, so we gotten another encounter card. This is Silver Thorn Dragon Tamer, Lucian. So yes, this is the encounter Lucian, the D series one. So let's go through what Lucian does. Okay, so we have Silver Thorn Dragon Tamer Lucian. Vanguard Circle, once per turn, cost Counterblast 1, put a card from your hand into your soul. Choose up to 3 unit cards with different grades from your soul, call them to Vanguard Circle. And if your opponent's Vanguard is 3 or greater, all of the units called get power plus 5k until the end of the turn. Second skill, at the end of your turn, put 2 of your rear guards into your soul, draw a card.
Wow, okay, so this card is really good. So basically, it's like the old Lucian where you call 3 units, you call units with different grades. The old one is called a different grade, so you can call from 0, 1, 2, 3 to Rega Circle, and then this one costs 3, but this one only costs 3, and it gets, and all units gets power plus 5k. And her second skill, man, it gives me V-Series Lucian vibes, man. I can't remember what's that card name called, where you can put all of your rear guards into your soul, then for each 2 rear guards you put into your soul, you draw a card. So yeah, this card is amazing, Lucian. So yeah, that is another encounter card. So we got 2 of the boss encounter cards. Let's see if we can get Minerva. Let's just see here. Okay, so this is a double R. This is for the right line for Minerva. Just like I mentioned Minerva, so this is the grade 2 right line. This is a double R for right line. So yeah, the other right lines are all rares or commons. So yeah, wondering why Minerva gets the special treatment. So yeah, another 2 rare pack. Okay, another 2 rare pack. Last pack from the right. And we have another double R. So this is the double R that I put just now, the counter channel. This is our third copy, by the way. And we have a triple R for Dragon Empire and Stochea. So I believe this is for the Stochea plant token deck. So let's just see what it does.
Okay, so we have Unwavering Flame Sword Radinia. So skill is, on Radar Circle at the beginning of your main phase, if you do not have a Momo K token on your Radar Circle, call up to one Momo K token to Radar Circle. Second skill, Glitter Roroa. Active if your Vanguard is Roroa. Then end of the battle, where your rear guard is ready, Lina is cutting your attack. If your opponent's Vanguard is ready, your greater retire cost, retire rear guard with ready Lina in his card name and a Momo K token. Call his new card into rear guard circle and increase that unit power by the power of the Momo K token retired for the cost of his ability until the end of the turn.
Okay, so it's basically an additional attack for the Stochea Grade 3, which is pretty interesting, and he has the ability to called a new token called a MomoK token. I'm not sure what a MomoK token is. So yeah, let me just research it later. So yep, that's cool. Oh, if you notice guys, we did pull a double R and a triple R in the same pack, and just now we put a FR and a triple R in the same pack. So that's our left right side of the box. Let's move on to the left side of the box. Let's finish this opening. Okay, a double rare pack. Oh wow, okay, so we got two orders. This is the Lukia order and this is the Angelica order. So yeah, that's pretty cool. That's very nice. Okay, a double R and an FR. Okay, nice. Okay. So we got a Chaos order, double R, and we got the Maelstrom order in FR. That looks beautiful. Really nice. So yeah, let's move on. Okay, another double rare pack. I still haven't seen the other triple R, which is Tidal Assault, which I'm hoping to get because I need Tidal Assault for my Maelstrom deck. Okay, let's see here. And we have another triple R. Okay, sorry, this is a double R. This is another card that I need. This is Wheel Assault, which is pretty good. It lets you swap positions after you boost, but it costs a Soul Blast, unlike the V series one, which was free. So yeah, that's pretty good. That's one of the double R's we need. Okay, we have a triple R here. This is, I'm guessing this is the brand new Maple. This is the Great One Maple. So yeah, Maple has become a Great One. So let's just see what this Maple does. Okay, so we have Pink Moth Girl Maple. Auto for drop when your Victory or Greater Vanguard is placed during the right phase, if you persona right this turn and you do not have Pink Moth Girl Maple on a Rega Circle, you may call this card to Rega Circle. If you call this, you will get power to fight it until the end of the turn. Second skill is Greater Dergia active if your Vanguard is Greater with Dergia in its name. Auto back row Rega Circle. When your unit in the same column as this unit stands, you may stand this unit. If you do, at the end of the battle, retire this unit. Okay, so this is the Great One Maple, which does almost the same thing as the Great Two Maple, but it only costs herself if you don't have her at all. And she has the Dragonic Overlord V series bite, where if your Vanguard stands, you stand her as well. So yeah, this is a really strong card. And it's a 13k booster. Wow, that is amazing. And Dergia, just nice, is a restander. So yeah, if you use the Dark Restander, Dark Dergia and restand, you can restand her as well. This is a really strong card. God damn. Okay, we have double rare pack. This is the red line for the Hill Moon. And last pack. Let's see what we end off with. Okay, our last pack, we end off with a double R. Oh, okay. So we got another one of these EX cards. This is the Great Zero EX. This is EX05. Unfortunately, I do not have translation, so I do not know what they do. But yeah, so our last pack, we got another EX. So I'm guessing we get an EX per box. I'm guessing so. So yeah, let's just run through our pools. For usual, we put an EX. We put 1, 2, 3, 4 triple R's, but only one encounter card. And we put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 double R's and 2 FR's. So yeah, our second box, not too bad again. But we got the EX, we got his starter. I'm guessing this is the starter, right? This is a Great Zero, right? So yeah, I'm pretty sure we do get an EX per box. And for some reason I always pull it on the last pack. I don't know why, but yeah, maybe it's like fate, I guess. So yeah, our second box, we got Lukia. So yeah, that is the box opening of the DBT 08, guys. Hope you guys enjoy my unboxing video of this pack. I have to say, this pack is quite an interesting pack to to open. We have Hololife cards from Lyrical Mysterio. If you are into Lyrical Mysterio and Hololife, please, if you're really into that, then just get this box. And if you're an encounter fan like me, like we have Lukia here and we have Maelstrom here, this box, I have to say, it's pretty good. So yeah, that's all for today, guys. Hope you guys enjoy DBT08 Minerva Rising. Sadly, we didn't pull any high rarity, or we didn't even pull any Minerva, but I can't complain because it's like a normal unbox opening. So yeah, sadly, guys, we did not manage to reach 300 subs by the end of today. Today is the unboxing. Today is the release of DBT08. So sorry, guys, we're not gonna do the special giveaway of the one box of DBT08. But you might never know, in the future, if I'm feeling generous again, I may be doing a special giveaway like this again. But please do take that opportunity. Don't let this opportunity go away. So yeah, that's all for today, guys. I will still be doing my 300 subs giveaway. Do one giveaway. Please do continue subscribing to my channel and stay tuned for more. And of course, I'll be doing my deck profile of my Blue Storm Dragon Maelstrom deck. And I'll be taking out for Cardfight videos as well. So please do stay tuned for that. And yeah, that's all for today, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. You can follow me down in the links description down in the description box below. So yeah, that's all for today, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. This is Jayhan Spirit 22 signing off.